Process Book has a feature that allows you to trend data sets. Now, a data set can be either something that comes from an ODBC compliant relational database or something that's a calculated data set. So when people want to do some quick and dirty ad hoc calculation, they can do that in Process Book. Now here's an example of how we can automate that. For example, the trend in blue is a data set, and I can just submit different queries to the data set. For example, using performance equation syntax, I'll say, let's go with, how about the value of sinusoid, the value of sinusoid plus the value of BA colon level dot 1 divided by 4. We'll go ahead and change the expression. As you can see, the values are coming in differently. And if I divide that by 2, I can change the expression and get different results. I can say, let's just go with the value of sinusoid itself. And as you can see, of course, it is synchronized. Now this is, by default, it's using, I believe, a 10-minute interval here. So that's what we're seeing. And I've decided to trend this as though it were a square wave plot, but that's up to you. Now, if you haven't done this manually before, you would do this in the definition of Process Book displays. So here's my definition. I would go into datasets, and I would create a new, this is going to be a pie calculation. Let's look at my existing calculation. Here's my existing calculation, and as you can see, I was editing this programmatically. Excuse me, I did that rather quickly. Here's what I was editing. As I was editing things in the text box, when I hit on the calculation, that sent that over here, which recalculated and showed me different results. Now, let's take a look at the code behind that. It's really quite simple. We have, very similar to what we did with getting the format of a trend, we have a datasets collection, and we can use the GetDataSet and specify the name of the dataset. Now, if you recall from our previous, when I showed you my previous screen, my dataset was called MYDS for my dataset. I used X as a variable of type dataset from the Process Book object library. So this is now pointing to the current dataset. It has an expression. As you can see, it has an expression. What's the right word? Property. It's a property that I was surprised to find didn't show up in IntelliSense. I'm not quite exactly sure why, but it does work nonetheless. X.expression is the expression for that data set object, and I'm going to set that expression equal to the results of the text box, or the what's in the text box. And then I simply use the set data set when I'm done. We did a set data set of X, which put that back into the datasets collection with the new changes.